What's the point in making all these intellectual films, you know, and if people don't like it, what's the point? You must give the people what they want, seems to be the argument against what I think is good and different cinema. And this is a very dangerous argument, in my opinion. Giving the people what they want is the dope peddler's argument. You know, even the dope peddler will argue that you must give the people what they want. They want to have dope, so give them dope. Who are you to say that they can't have dope? There is, when it comes to difference in terms of art, you must go against the grain of the popular. That is what makes a difference. I don't think any achievement into art was achieved when you went with the grain of the popular, when you just went with the herd, when you just flowed with what was common and what was commonplace. Then you got commonplace art, not extraordinary art, not difficult art. It's true that with time that art can become, I think, iconic, can become very popular, can become pervasive. When, let's say, even if you talk about Picasso and Goya, Guernica, I mean, it has a resonance in terms of the Spanish Revolution, of a bombing of a village. There's a whole history that is implicit in that art, and therefore it has value. It is popular in that sense. So I think this whole argument about being popular and even being populist, unfortunately, in South India, we are a different filmmaker is fighting the philosophy of the popular and the populist. And I have no hesitation in saying that much of the cinema that we face in Tamil or Malayalam, of which I know something, the part of the struggle is to get away from the aesthetic of this populist cinema. It's okay. I think it's one thing to see, let's say, the iconic figures, the stars, the superstars of the previous years and today, the reigning stars, to understand what they have done, to recognize what they have done. But I think it is equally important to be honest about it in a seminar in this context and say that they have also destroyed good cinema. Purely by persisting in those values that will not yield good cinema. I can see that happening in Malayalam, for instance. Two superstars have destroyed 80% of good cinema in Malayalam. But they are at the same time good artists. They can do good films at the same time, but they choose to do bad films and choose to perpetuate the culture of bad films. So you can't but blame them. That is true of Tamil cinema as well. I think our superstars are capable of great artistry, a great performance, some of them are. But they choose to do run-of-the-mill, choose to do the stereotype, and choose to persist in perpetuating that myth that this is what the people want. So I think unless we take them on, I don't think you'll have different cinema happening in this part of the world. How do we relate to international cinema? I don't think we want to relate to Hollywood in the common sense of the term, because one of the biggest problems with cinema in the world today is the Hollywoodization. Everywhere you go, you see Hollywood. If you went to Europe today and checked into a hotel and switched on the television, you'll see a German film and an American and a French film which is dubbed into English. Or you'll see a Hollywood film which is, dubbed into German or French. Like you see Tamil films now, if you switch on one of the channels, you'll see Hollywood films dubbed into Tamil. So there is that kind of invasion, that kind of road-rollering of Hollywood that's taking place on the one hand. And you're therefore fighting tremendous odds when you're making good cinema. The objective conditions have also changed. Cinema has become more distilled in terms of its perception, in terms of its viewership. We're talking about multiplexes where an ordinary person can't really go because the ticket is very expensive. You don't have the B and C circuits in cinema anymore. There is no ruralness in much of Indian cinema. Tamil is far better actually. If you look at Hindi cinema, there is no ruralness in Hindi cinema anymore. There was a time in the 60s and 70s and 80s when there is this Ram Sham kind of character. You know, there's a character who goes from the city to the village and rediscovers his roots, or the character from the village who comes to the city. There is the rootedness of the village, which is the preponderant reality of India. 70% of our people continue to live in villages. India continues to be a rural economy. But if you look at the Hindi cinema today, the mainstream Hindi cinema, you will think you're living in some other world. It's not only city-oriented, it's NRI-oriented. It's not even, related to Bombay or Calcutta or Delhi. It's all meant for New York and London and Paris and Montreal or whatever have you.